Coast Sling here at Studio One, and we did two patterns today, basically. We started with our continuous tuck-in. It looks like this. Back, break, trip, full step, trip, full step, back, break, one, two, back, break, one, two, back, break, one, two, back, break, exit, basic timer.
So Liz, what are we doing? We basically tuck in the very beginning. Back, break, trip, full step, trip, full step. We change hands, we're gonna bring hand through for the back break. Back, break. At the same time, offering my left hand. I'm gonna go across for one, step back, two, pick up the other hand. Back, break, make sure this hand comes forward and off the hand. Repeat, one, two, back, break. Once on the third one, one, two. I'm keeping the left hand, not doing anything with the right hand. Do a back, break, then do an underarm turn. Bring them back to close position. Back to basic timing.
All right, followers. We are going to feel the leader ask us for single count timing because he's doing single count timing. So leaders, it's super important that you're demonstrating that through your connection. So after we do our basic tuck, but. At this point, we don't know that anything's different, right, followers? The leader coming towards us kind of cuts us off in this motion, and the kind of swoop with the tuck portion is giving us that timing of one, two, and then back, break, and then a one, two, and then back, break. So leader's making sure that you're demonstrating that timing through your connection. And then basically, followers, we shift back to basic timing when he hasn't told us that that's not what we should be doing. Okay. Next, we did a
shadow turns. We go to the cross and hold. We're going to go back. Leaders counts first. So we got back, break, one, two, back, break, trip, full step, back, break, trip, full step, back, break, one, two, back, break.
And followers, our counts are back, break, trip, full step, 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 back, break. So leaders, you're holding, as you noticed, at the beginning and at the end. Important things, we have to demonstrate to the follower that the timing is changing at this point here. So leaders, you want to make sure you're connected to her shoulder with your wrist. And connected here, making sure that we lead the follower to back, break, bringing her forward again so she doesn't triple back into you. Okay? Same thing on the other side. Back, break, really leading the timing of the pattern. From there, we added a single spin on one side. Back, break, triple, back, break, triple, back, break, turn, back, break, triple, back, break, turn, back, break, here's our exit. We also did turns on both sides. Back, break, triple, back, break, turn, 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 back, break, turn, 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 back, break, turn, 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 back, break. When we're ready to exit, we don't turn, we keep the hand down.
Players, know which hand you're turning with is whatever hand on your midline. So we're gonna fix them right this way. So we're breaking back right here. My left hand on midline, that's the one that turns. Turn, turn, turn. Right hand's on the midline, when we take this back break, this hand's gonna turn. Bop, bop, bop. So whatever hand's on that midline is gonna be the hand's gonna turn the follower.
Yes, important concept, two things. Front loading your turn, making sure that the turn starts nice and quick so you have a breath to collect yourselves before this back break at the end, front loading that turn. The other thing is, leaders, we want to make sure that we're reconnecting before that back break. Because if we're going to do double turns, we have to make sure we've gotten that hand and have established that connection here so we can turn with that hand, and here so we can turn with that hand.
Yep.
Anything else? Nope. That is it. Thank you guys so much.
Thanks.